key to this streak you guys have been on?
Getting the ball to Leon Robbins. I mean, he's been playing like the best player in the country these past couple games. Over the last 10, I think he's averaging 18.7 or something like that, something crazy. So he's been carrying us for sure. Ezra's been electric for us as well, just getting those two in the pick and roll, involving them in our sets. And, you know, other guys just making plays. Trey's been hitting. Miles got hit a couple shots the last game. So, you know, everybody just kind of feeding off those two and their energy and just playing defense.
You know, Liam has been kind of progressing because he, you know, was obviously out at the beginning of the season. Do you see him kind of finding his own way now?
For sure, for sure. You see every aspect of his game coming together now. In the beginning of the season, he was kind of just dominating low posts and rebounding, but now he's stretching now, stretching the floor for us. He's been shooting the ball at an extremely high rate, hitting the mid-range shots, hitting threes. So you see his whole game, he's still rebounding the ball at a high level as well. So he's putting his whole game together, got his good rhythm right now.
You've got a big game tomorrow. What does Auburn do well that's going to give you guys trouble?
For sure, the athleticism is really impressive. They're sixth in the country in defense, I think sixth in steals as well. So they wreak havoc on the defensive end as well, just getting out in transition. They haven't shot the ball well this year, but they got hot against Missouri. You saw that in the way they kind of handled Missouri the last game out there. So just they play fast, they play aggressive, they play free. So it's a tough challenge for us this Saturday.
I know they're athletic. Is their length going to be a problem for you guys at all?
I hope not. I mean, it's hard to predict, but I mean, we've seen teams with length. We've seen teams with great defenses. We've seen it all. So, you know, just got to come out and play our game, run our sets, execute the way we have been.
I don't know if you look at the ticket prices or anything for tomorrow, but it feels like there's a little bit of a buzz behind you guys. Do you feel that right now?
For sure, for sure. The momentum is definitely brewing, is definitely in our favor right now. It's something that I haven't been a part of in my whole career here in my 4 years. But I haven't felt this type of momentum, haven't felt as rowdy of a game, you know, as this is expected to be. So, yeah, definitely for sure I feel it.
As kind of one of the leaders of this team, how do you deal with that as when you talk to other guys around the team?
For sure. You hate to say it's just another game. It's not. It's definitely a big game, but you want to take that mentality in it. We approach it the same way, make sure we don't miss any steps, guys getting the extra work in, guys making sure we get our work in the film room, making sure we're locked in and focused on practice, just handling things that we know we're capable of.
For tomorrow, what do you think kind of the keys are for you guys to come out and really attack Auburn like you have the last few games?
For sure, for sure. I think establishing Liam early is going to be a big part of the game, making sure he gets going, and then also with Ezra and everyone else. Instead of that first five, making sure they get a good rhythm in the game like they did against South Carolina, like they did against Florida. Those guys have been coming out in that first 5 minutes and absolutely just dominating the game, so definitely expect to do that again against Auburn.
Besides great coaching, what's been the key to this little run?
I think our guys have really locked in over the last few games, and we're making less mistakes. I think that's the key to it. Even going back, I thought our defense was really good last time out against South Carolina. We didn't shoot the ball great, but still was able to get some separation because of just the attention to detail and really following the game plan. And that, I mean, you know, we graded out probably like 70% of our defensive possessions that, you know, we were correct, and we hadn't had a number, you know, like that before. So, I mean, I think if we continue to trend that way defensively and still stay confident in our shots, continue to move the ball, we got great looks, you know, we have a chance to win every game we play.
There's been lots of talk about you talking to Tyron. Have you talked to Liam about elevating his game at all? Because he's really, I don't know what's been the key to his success here as a player.
I just think Liam has grown. I mean, he's grown as a player. I think he's grown as a teammate from early in, you know, the season to from last year. I just think it was a lot of frustration from not being able to play. I think it came out at, you know, certain times during just his comeback to where he needed to be. But I mean, I think he's just been really great at understanding what we need for him to do. Really, really great at taking all the little things that we do daily, really serious and focusing in. And it's fun to watch all these guys, not just Liam, not just Tyron, but a lot of our younger guys. You know, Ezra, you know what I'm saying? He's a lot different player now than he was when he first got here, trying to understand our system, where we need him to be impactful. And I think a lot of it comes down to, you know, really redefining yourself sometime. You know, it's not whatever vision that you may have had for yourself, you know, coming into a season, it doesn't always pan out that way. But, you know, understanding and accepting whatever is needed for the team to be successful. And I think we got great guys that have bought into that and now We're able to showcase that by how we play basketball, how we play team basketball together on both ends of the floor.
With Liam, he's been able to step out a little bit throughout the last few games, the three threes in two games. Has there been a change in anything, or is it just knowing that he's a good shooter all along and the shots can stop falling?
Yeah, I just think it's. I think Liam is just being comfortable. He's more comfortable, you know, as a basketball player. I think he's comfortable with his health. We've always known he had a great touch, even when he, you know, probably wasn't shooting a high percentage as he is now. He probably the last three or four games he's shooting over 70% from three. You know what I'm saying? Probably early in the season. You know, I guess there was. I drew up a play for him to win a game, and everybody was like, well, what's wrong? Why you draw it for your center? Because we see him shoot it every day and know that he's capable of hitting those shots and making big plays for us. He's not afraid of the moment, as he's shown in the Florida game, you know, when they were making a little bit of run, and, you know, he stepped up and, you know, knocked down a big shot. He did the same thing in South Carolina, but it's about finding that balance. I mean, as much as he's capable of being a threat for us on the perimeter, he's give opposing teams a lot more issue when he's rolling and when he's down on the block, because not only is he a threat down there, but that opens up things for his teammates as well. So it's just, you know, having that balance. I always tell him, I like the threes in transition. I mean, if you get the rebound, then you can shoot a three in transition. But if you don't get the rebound, then you don't get to shoot a three in transition. So we got a, you know, little something going on there. And I just think it encourages him to rebound out of his position, and then, you know, with those outlets, and we got guys that can really get up the floor and attack as he trail in, he has the freedom to take those shots when he gets the rebound. So I think those that's the key to that. But no, just our guys, just yesterday's practice was a really, really focused practice. I'm looking forward to, you know, the same thing today. Guys coming back really, really serious, wanting to get better, knowing that we have a lot to play for, and if we focus in and lock in to our game plan and compete at a high level, like I said, we have a chance to go out and win every game we play.
I don't know if you've got a chance to see the ticket prices or anything for tomorrow, but it feels like there's kind of a level of buzz. How would you describe the feel around the program right now?
Well, again, we're just focusing in, you know, internally. You know what I'm saying? We can't worry about anything outside of that. I mean, obviously, we know our students have been unbelievable whenever they've been on campus. Our overall fan support has been great for us. So we're just, you know, we're ecstatic to be able to have this type of momentum and this type of buzz and excitement around our team. It's not that, you know, we just haven't had that, you know, and maybe haven't had the product to be able to get that much that type of excitement about. But now it's a lot of fun. But for us, We got to always tell our guys, we got to create our own enthusiasm. We can't worry about, because we go in a hostile environment sometimes and they're not cheering for us. Or we go to a situation where it's not a lot of, you know, not a lot of fanfare. You know, we can't count on that to be who we need to be. We just need to focus on ourselves and really what's happening within the 94 feet. And when we do that, we're pretty good.
When you guys have been on the street, you haven't turned the ball over really. Seven a game, it seems like. Auburn doesn't make that easy. What's kind of the key for you guys to take care of the ball and keep those possessions?
Yeah, I mean, this is a very, very handsy team that really gets after you defensively. But I think it's just, you know, just protecting the ball, being strong with the ball, doing the fundamental things that we work on every day, bringing those things to the game. It's really where it's at. You know, we still have to be aggressive. We still have to screen. To pull triggers, allow that our guys are able to get downhill, to get a little, freedom from their defensive assignment. But, we played other teams before. Again, I think that we're well tested. You know, we played. I think that's why we feel that we're equipped to play this. We played the VCUs. We played the teams that have the same similar type of style of being aggressive and whatnot. And I think we've learned things from those games that hopefully help us handle any pressure or anything like that. It's just about us being us, man. We don't worry so much about what the other teams do. It's just about what we know that we're capable of doing. And when we do that, we give ourselves a great chance to be successful.